Now for the top story tonight, reaction, joining us from Pensacola, Florida, Mike Papantonio, liberal radio talk show host, and from Washington, Penny Lee, former senior advisor to Senate Majority Leader Harry Reid. So, Ms. Lee, how much damage do you think the president is doing to himself and the Democratic Party with this mosque business?
Well, the sheer fact that we're still talking about it 3 days later tells you we are definitely in the dog days of August. I was talking to some campaign managers that are out there, and, you know, they are disappointed that they are having to address this in their local elections right now. So there is some damage and there is some fallback. But I think at the end of the day, when we get into September, into October, when people are really starting to focus on the election itself, it will still be about the economy and jobs. So, yes, this does have taken some folks off of their own message these last couple of days, but I think they'll be back on it, and the election will be more about jobs than,
okay,
than the mosque.
But you don't think people are going to forget about this? See, isn't it a cumulative effect? It is for me, and I hope you both feel that I've been fair to President Obama, because I think I have. But it's one crazy thing after another. Ms. Lee, if you were an advisor to the president, you certainly would have told him, don't go near this. It doesn't do you any good.
And
emotions
I'm sure
are raw here. Stay out of it.
Right?
Right.
Right. And I'm sure that there are people that did say exactly that in the White House. That just said, leave this to the local officials.
Yeah, so what is he getting involved for?
So the president, you know, was trying to walk that fine line in saying what is allowable and what is advisable.
Everybody
and
knows
what he was trying to
allowable.
Say is, what was it? I understand. But this is a man who ran from very beginning, if you remember early in his campaign, that says we need to change the dialogue with the Muslim community. We need to change the next generation doesn't
you know,
grow up
with all
to
due respect,
Americans.
Ms. Lee, he needs to change the dialogue with the American people right now, because he's getting his butt
agree.
Kicked. In the polls, he's going to be down in the 30s next week. What do you say, Mike?
Well, I mean, the thing that separates real leadership from a political hack is the political leader has to stand up for issues that mob mentality may not go along with. There's no question. You're right, Bill. The vast majority of Americans think this is a wrong move. Was it avoidable? No, it wasn't. At some point, the question was going to come up, what do you think? So his choice is to act like a leader or to cave in and say, look, I'm going to do what the mob wants me to do. That's the difference
leadership. What you're saying is that he's strong. A powerful leader to address this controversial case. Then he says, I'm not going to comment on the appropriateness of it. Come on, I just blew your argument right out of the water. He runs away from the key question. Is it appropriate, Mr. President? And he hightails it out of there.
The point is that question is going to come up again and again. Is
this, answer it then. Answer it.
Bill, here it is. Here's the answer. As this develops, as this controversy develops, I really do believe if he does what he should do as a leader, and that's to educate the American public about why this is an important issue, about how we're the envy of the world as a democracy, how the rest of the world wishes they could be us, and how the thing that sets us apart mostly is freedom of religion. If he will keep that argument up rather than, as you say, backing off from that argument, he's going to come out of this just
fine.
He's
not going to come out of it because he knows any thinking, fair-minded person, Ms. Lee, knows that you must take into consideration the feelings and sensitivities of those who lost loved ones on 9/11. All right? It is beyond a reasonable doubt that this is that this mosque is provoking emotion. You just heard the Muslim leader in Canada, who I had on last week, all right, say the exact same thing. Nobody's objecting to a mosque any place that is away from a reminder that Islamic killers did this atrocity. And I don't think President Obama understands the feelings of those who lost people on 9/11, Ms. Lee. I don't think he does.
Well, again, we also return back to what George Bush said, that this is a war on terror. This is not a war on Islam. And I think that is
important
to remember
as we go
forward.
Well, who's funding this thing? Nobody knows who's funding it.
We don't know, but what we're saying is that this cultural center that could and should and may be built there on those grounds is one that's going to encourage tolerance and one that's going to encourage dialogue.
How do we know that? We don't know that.
The
imam in charge has said, wait a minute, we got to deal with facts, Ms. Lee. The imam in charge has said very dubious things, all right? We don't know where the money's coming from.
And he's also said very tolerant things, and he's also said they're against the radical, and he's also voiced his own intolerance or his own objections against the radicalisms that often occur in Islam. So there is both sides on the
imam. You can have your cake and you can have you can eat it too. You can have the mosque in a place that doesn't set off this firestorm of emotion. All right, Mike, I'm going to ask you one more question here. If you were advising President Obama, would you tell him, Mr. President, you made a mistake by dodging the issue of appropriateness? You must go out and say whether you believe it's appropriate or not and why. Would you advise him to do that?
I'd advise him to do it immediately. He can't back down. He's in it. Whether he wants to be or not, he is in this issue. The thing to do is not to look equivocal about it. It's like Mike Gerson said, wonderful statement by Mike Gerson. He used to be George W. Bush's
speechwriter.
He says, look,
he's gonna be
this
on
is a chance for him to be everybody's president.
Well, all right. Well, I hope the president takes your advice, because the appropriateness of the issue is really the entire issue. Nobody's saying the mosque shouldn't be built legally.